Everyone, my name is Miraç. I am a Bilkent Electronic Engineering student, and today I want to talk about the project that I've built using the BASIS board, BASIS 3 board, and Vivado. The purpose of this project was to design a simple audio spectrogram, which takes an audio signal using the microphone here, as you can see, and then it converts this signal to the amplitude frequency graph, so that we can see the signal has which frequencies at which amplitude. So basically in a spectrogram, and then to output it using the VGA driver right here. And now let's look at the code. This is the Vivado block design diagram that I've designed. So the PMOD mic, as you can see here, that I've bought externally, and this is a peripheral microphone which has an ADC built in, so that it takes the audio signal and converts to digital, in which way I can use it in the BASIS board. It works with the SPI serial peripheral interface bus, and the FFT module, the Fourier transform module, that which is needed to take the signal and transfer it into frequency domain. I've used the Vivado IP core for this, and it works with an interface called AXI or AXI. Vivado has standardized their interface for all the IP cores, so I had to use that one. And to connect my SPI slave microphone to this Fourier transform module, I had to put in a intermediate module, the AXI quad SPI, which takes the SPI data from the slave and transforms it into AXI, which the FFT module can use. As you can see, we have the SS, the clock, and the master in slave out. These are the ports on the PMOD mic that I have to communicate with. We have the clock 100 megahertz from the board itself. We have the clock wizard, which takes that, and this is also an IP core, so that a 25 megahertz clock, which I need to use on my quad SPI module, the FFT module, and also the VGA driver. They both use the same clock. They all use the same clock. And so I've connected the ports to the quad CPI simply. Then I connected that to the Fourier transform module. This is the clock wizard. As you can see, I have made the necessary connections for the data, and there are various signals like ready and valid, which the AXI interface uses. And there is a constant IP core, which I used to just connect the resets here and here to a constant low, so that they don't reset, because I don't need this. And this is the simple VGA driver, which takes the data, the clock, and has a reset, and it generates the necessary ASIC, VSync, and RGB values to, as you, these are external ports, to show the data on the screen, basically. And here is the general setup. And now we're going to plug in the BASIS port to VGA on my television screen and see how it works. So as you can see, I've connected the BASIS port to the VGA on my television, and I have also programmed it, as you can see here. It's programmed by the computer. Now, here you can see the program's working, and it's reacting to my voice. But to test this, I have downloaded an audio function app. Let me show it here. A second. Here it is, function generator. It generates the frequency I want in sinus, square, or triangular waves. I'll just use the sinus and square to show the overtones and the etc. And let's now start by pushing the play. And as you can see, let's put it closer. As you can see, this is an 880 hertz signal, a sinus wave, so it actually has the highest amplitude here in the first one, as you can see. The others are overtones, because although I generate a sine wave, there are multiple, like there's a microphone, there are speakers, which generate also overtones. And you can see the, here, let me be silent and see the frequency. Now, also I haven't had time to plot the frequency scale. Because apparently writing out ASCII characters on VGA is a whole another mess. And so let's try another frequency now. Actually, let's increase it by... Yeah. As you can see, there are less overtones. This is... what's it? This is 1780 hertz. As you can see. And these are all sinus waves. So let's try square wave now to see how the overtones change. Let's decrease a little bit. A bit too loud. Sorry about that. Closer. As you can see, there are a lot of more overtones on the square wave. So basically, a square wave is made up of a whole lot more sinusoidal waves summed up to create this frequency. It's down there. So of course, the idea behind Fourier transform is that every signal can be represented as an infinite or finite sum of sinusoidal waves. For example, when we hear a simple sinus wave with, for example, let's say 440 hertz frequency, this means that this signal, if we convert it to a frequency amplitude graph, we will only see a peak at 440, representing that frequency which the signal is built on. For example, if you had a different signal with overtones, this is a sum of multiple sinusoids with frequency integer multiples of the base frequency, but so amplitude decreases when it's not the base frequency, and the base frequency has the most increased amplitude, and we could see that on the graphs here. So yes, this is the end of my project. Thank you for listening. Have a good semester break, I guess.